spout has basically three typical responsibilities. One, of course, it would be connecting to a specific data source. That data source, as many a times we have talked about, can be anything. Then anything means it could be database, queue, or text file, or something else, right? So, or probably API itself. Then it would basically be getting the tuples all together from the data source. And the third thing would be using any of the stream combinations, whatever we have talked about, it would be sending the tuples within the topology. That's the overall purpose of spout, existing, okay? One important thing, have you noticed this part that your basically spout is making the connection to the source of data? It is not the other way around, okay? Guys, this is important, okay? I mean, you can, spout can get the data, right? So any of you, like many of you are already some experienced guys, so you know, right? What might be the reason behind this? What might be the reason behind this? Why basically spout is making the connection? Why not sources are? Exactly, it is pulling, that's correct. So typically data pulling is supposed to be a better technique, the reason being because if, let's say, the servers are not available, the failure mechanisms and all can be written at the spout itself rather than putting the push logic on the sources side. Because what if you deploy your topology once more? Then your spout might be running on a separate machine altogether, right? Might be running on a separate machine altogether. In that case, your basically sources of data, basically the failure would be much more, or that I would say it is much more difficult to do the let's say correction on the source of data side of I would say debugging itself. Next is, this is where the things start. So Storm provides a simple API basically for implementing spout. The spout, basic spout, is base rich spout, which you'd be using it. Okay, just a sec. Maybe one more advantage can be speed at which stream could be pulled. Maybe push, we do not have the control. Partially, yes, you can say so, Arpan. Only thing is, it is not applicable on all of the kind of data sources. That's why I would say this advantage which you are mentioning is not generic, right? So if it is a queue kind of thing, then probably it doesn't really matter, right? So correct. Now coming back quickly here, so it is about, you can actually see this public class first spout. The base spout, which you have to always extend in almost all of the examples, you will be seeing the base rich spout, which is going to be extended altogether. And the example would be, so see this, these are the methods which are required. Guys, this is the, I would say, gist. This is the anatomy. And all of your business logic is going to be completely within these methods themselves. So base rich spout, and you have to provide the implementation for method called open, method called next tuple, method called ACK, method called fail. Now ACK and fail are something, even if you do not provide any implementation, I repeat, ACK and fail, even if you do not provide any implementation, that is completely okay. Okay, that is completely okay. However, it will come with a price. Okay, we will see the price also. Now, this is something which will give you overall idea that what is next tuple, when to call what, and what kind of logic has you written in which logic, right? In which function? Because right now Vishal is showing you one example. He will get away after this class, or probably in the next class, or under 2-3 classes, right? But after this, it would be you who have to decide which function has to happen where. So first thing, let's start with activate. So activate is something which I have not even implemented. The reason is simple. Activate is the method which will be called when a spout has been activated out of a deactivated mode. Do you remember? So when would this scenario happen? I did tell about activate command in last class and deactivate command and the difference between you know this and basically kill command also, right? Killed is one, disabled and enabling also. There were two more commands, right? Suspending them. So you disable it and then when you reactivate it, or you deactivate it and then when you reactivate the entire topology itself, if there are any one-time activities which you want to perform, that is something which you will do via activate. And similarly, the same thing would be used when you are doing it for the deactivation. So whatever happens, so probably what kind of logic? So I mean, I have provided you the method, I have told you this is where it would be used, but then the question would be what kind of logic should have been written. So probably the typical kind of logic would be, as soon as you're activating it, if there are any lookups, you want to refresh them, right? Irrespective of any signal. So these kind of one type of setup, right? You have just started it and you just wanna refresh basically your logs and all. That is where basically your this entire activate and deactivate would come into place. And while you are deactivating it, probably let's say you have made some database connections, right? You want to suspend them, you want to close them altogether, right? So just as a fail-safe thing, right? So this is about activate deactivate. Now the close is something when the spout is shut down. So when you kill, okay, when you kill a topology, at that time close method would be called, okay? Storm will be calling this close method. So just in case when you are closing it, you want to do some sort of cleanup activities, this exactly is the place where you do those things. Okay guys, so almost same kind of logic can be written between the deactivate and close. Same kind, I'm not saying the exactly same kind of thing. So while deactivating it, you might want to persist some of the state, right? You might want to persist the state by serializing it, and when you activate it, you would like to recover it back. But when you close it, you want to do a complete cleanup. Right now I'm connecting all those dots. I have given you enough information from this point onwards up to probably the next class. It is only the connecting dots part. Next is the fail. Okay, so fail and ACK, they go to hand in hand, ACK and fail. So guys, typically your spouts are of two types, okay? One are called the non-reliable spouts, other are called the reliable spouts. You remember that reliability thing which we talked about? So Storm provides you the guarantee that your tuple would be floated within the cluster once, but whether it got processed, do you want to keep a track of it or not, right? That is something which you have to decide from the spout side. So spout has emitted the tuple, but what happened to it? Like, so there might be some two more bolts which might be consuming that tuple and want to do some processing on it, right? There would be a scenario. So whether spout want to take care of this or not, if it wants to take care, then it is called the reliable spout. If it does not want to take care, then it is called the unreliable spout. Okay, so all the reliable spouts apply ACK and fail method. Now okay, open and next tuple. About the open part, open is something as soon as, let's say you have created multiple instances, right, of a spout. So as soon as an instance is created, what are the initialization activities which have to be done, right? So let's say getting the collector instance, right, collector.emit, getting the configuration instance, getting the task information altogether, right? So all of these things, or let's say creating some sort of source altogether, right? Data source, connecting one time to the data source altogether, right? So those kind of logics would be written in the open method. Is that clear? Is that clear about open? Because next is the most important method due to which your entire storm works actually. This and the other one. Clear, right? Next is the next tuple method. Okay, this is the method which is responsible for floating the data in your cluster. Guys, this is the nucleus method. Clear? Next tuple. And storm makes sure that it just keeps on calling next tuple, next tuple, next tuple, next tuple. It's only and only next tuple which is called again and again. All of them are either called one time or on user request. So that is about the spout itself. Next is, so this was about the declaration part. This was about the different methods part. Now let's put all of that together in a simple example. So see this, open is called first time. What am I trying to get here? I'm just trying to get a collector instance for me, because collector is the guy which will be responsible for what, which this will be responsible for emitting the data, basically putting the data into the cluster. Okay, it's like context.write in Hadoop. Then see this, public void ACK, public void fail. Right now they are empty, or I could have simply removed them also. Okay, I could have removed them also, there is no problem. Only thing is, I'm just right now showing it, because as soon as I will talk about the reliable spouts, right, I would show you some, I mean, I'm not covering it like making a reliable spout and all, but it's all about, I'll show you what exactly is the kind of logic which you can write. Okay, some sample logic also there. But ACK fail, and then is the next tuple. Okay, now next tuple is something which is being called again and again. Now about the collector.emit, so if they are same, right, then remove the, then emit the hello world, otherwise just emit the other random world. This is another, you know, hard-coded string which I am emitting altogether, right? Is everybody able to understand it? So how would it behave? Storm will keep on calling it. As soon as it calls for 100 milliseconds, it would stop, and then it would try to generate some numbers. If they match, then it would, you know, either it would emit hello world or other random world. These would be the two inputs, or these would be the two outputs basically of the spout every time. And I hope the code walkthrough this way is much better also, because in Eclipse, right? Now coming to the ACK and fail, which I have left empty, the time has come to think about that. So now about the spout thing, so in the, there are two kinds of spouts which might be possible, which is, one is reliable spout, another one is the unreliable spout. So now this is your call as a programmer to take care that which kind of spout you want to implement. Okay, so what I mean by that is, let's say your spout is taking care or is reading, let's say, some bank transactions, and based on some bank transactions, I mean based on the whatever transaction it is, it wants to do some processing, right? Typically you would not like to lose your streams, or you would not like to lose your tuples, you know, at all. So there was some tuple processing failed, but you didn't track. Okay, so if this is the case for a banking scenario, you cannot afford it. But if you are getting a lot of data via Twitters in the form of tweet feeds altogether, and you are getting, let's say, 100,000 tweets, and if you lose, let's say, some 50 or 60 tweets in it, then probably it might not matter that much, right? Probably that may not matter that much, right? So that's the whole point, okay? So this is your responsibility whether you want to go for a reliable spout or not, right? So the scenarios will depend upon, I mean, it will be clearly be driven by the kind of business problem which you are trying to solve, right? Now, so it is just that spout provides mechanism for guaranteed processing. Of course, it comes with a price. And when I say with a price, it's all about, it would be a resource intensive operation, right? Your reliable topology, when you talk about it, it becomes a bit resource heavy because you have to track the tuples and each and every. So every time a spout has to go for an acknowledgement, a fail, if it happens on the fail side, what should happen next, right? So that kind of tracking also. At the same time, on the bolt side also the same story would go, right? Again, acknowledging, failing, what to do, in which case, right? So those kind of things would come. So naturally, if you are going for a reliable thing, of course, it will have some sort of performance, overhead. But when it comes for the unreliable, of course, those overheads would not be there. But remember, you may lose some tuples. That is something which is your conscious call. Guys, clear, right? It has to be a fine combination of both. Okay?